Affective disorder. They called it dyslexia back then. I also have bipolar with psychotic features. I'm not lying. And I also have chemically induced paranoid schizophrenia. I'm not lying. And myself.
So you're normal.
I'm normal, yeah. I'm in the norm. Anyway, I'm very obsessive compulsive. I have OCD. And I obsess over this thing about Johnny Cash all the time because not knowing who my father was. And I heard he was a musician. I heard he was that he had dark hair and he slicked it back and he was a famous musician. I don't know. Anyway, here we go.
Elvis.
Yeah, Elvis, that's right, yeah. Get me going on that one. Anyway, Johnny Cash dedicated this next song that he wrote to his youngest daughter, to Roseanne Cash, when she was yay high. And why he did that, I don't know. It has nothing to do with the father's love for his daughter. It has nothing to do with the little girl. It has everything to do with the little boy. So naturally, I obsessed and think he wrote it about me. And that's my ego. And I don't think it's true, but then again, I don't know. Stranger things have happened, okay? All I know is that my booking agent now in Nashville, Tennessee, just called me today, George Mallard. He's from here. He booked Reba McEntire, and he's working with me now. And he just opened a great door for us. Marty Stewart's sister just called. She heard our stuff. Marty Stewart heard it. He used to play for Johnny Cash, and they want me to come there soon and start this thing down there. And that has a lot to do with Johnny Cash. So this is really weird for me. And then he's also got an appointment to see John Carter Cash, Johnny Cash's son, who's really tall, taller than Johnny, and has red hair and a red beard and can't sing. I think they got us mixed up. Just kidding, don't tell him that. All I know is once we get permission from him, I guess if you need permission, we're gonna get DNA tests done. Okay, yeah, for sure, because there's a lot of people, even his best friend in Dice, Arkansas thinks I am, and so we're gonna find out. And I just know somewhere deep down inside, I can feel it. You know, how you can feel things, you know. When I get those tests back, I don't be on a shadow of a doubt. With my luck, we're going to find out I'm the long lost son of Tiny Tim. Anyway, Roseanne grew up to be a great country artist. And she recorded the same song that Johnny dedicated to her years ago and made it a number one hit. So we're going to go ahead and dedicated right back to the lovely Roseanne Cash. In a little cabaret in a South Texas border town sat a boy and his guitar, and the people came from all around, and all the girls from there to Austin. We're slipping away from home and putting jewelry in a car to take a trip to go and listen to the little dark-haired boy that played the Tennessee flat-top box, and he would play. And he never cared to make a dime, but give him his guitar, and he'd be happy all the time, and all the girls from 9 to 90 were slapping the fingers, tapping toes, and begging him don't stop and hypnotize. And fascinated by the little dark-haired boy that played the Tennessee flat-top box, and he would play. Forgot him in the little town, but all the girls still dreamed about him. And they hung around the cabaret until the doors were locked. And then one day, on the hit parade, was the little dark-haired boy that played the Tennessee flat-top box, and he would play.